All right, we're back working on this vintage Curtis air compressor again. I've got the local bearing shop tracking down bearings for the crankshaft. They've got one in stock, and he's going to call me back here in a little bit. He's trying to track down the rest of them. Fortunately, I was able to get good numbers off of these. So right now, I'm working on the valve housing. This is the intake side here, and then the outlet side here going to whatever you're going. There's a ball valve here. Going to whatever you're going to power with this thing. Eventually, I'm going to make some air whistles that are going to run off of this. But I've got the valves out, and as you can see, pretty crusty in there. Fortunately, no pitting or anything like that. Just crapped up, as we used to say at my old place of employment before I retired. It's all crapped up, so we're going to clean it up. Underneath that disc, there's a recessed retainer, and there's a spring under there. I still got to pull that out. And I'll do that, and then the housing is going to go in the parts washer and clean it all up. Here's the intake valve here. You can see it's actuated by this lever. There's the shaft and the spring goes into this housing here, and then this unit here, you can see, is just all crapped up. So I've got to clean up this inlet valve, and then this is the corresponding outlet valve here, spring and disc, and it also just needs a good cleaning. So I don't know if you can see or not. Probably not. Let's see. No, never mind. Yeah. Anyway, so long story short, I'm working on the valves. Hope to get them cleaned up. I'll get this back together. And then once I get bearings, we'll start reassembling this thing. And I still got to pull the sump off and clean up the inside of that. Hey, an interesting little thing. Well, grab the light. You see this ring right here? It rides on the crankshaft. I wasn't sure what that was for. And you can see it's retained by that cast iron hook shape in the bottom. See that ring? I was asking my buddy Jim about that, since this is where this came from. That's the oil slinger for this. And I've never seen a slinger like that before. Usually you see something attached to the bottom bearing cap for slinging oil. Not on this. So again, an unusual design. You know, the flywheel, this doesn't have a valve that controls you know, the release or the relief. This one's done by RPM. That'll be featured in a later video, that setup that's attached to the flywheel. All right. I've talked long enough. There you go. An update on the Curtis air compressor. Have a great day, everybody.